Welcome. This is Ad Emmen reporting live for Premier Magazine from the IC conference, but not live from Frankfurt. At the COVID-19 session, people were discussing how high-performance computing and supercomputing could help research in COVID-19. One of the presenters was Rick Stevens from Argonne, and this was his opening screen. And yeah, what's that he doing in the background? Of course, we know Rick Stevens, but in the background, yeah, it's a coronavirus. So it's not the typical picture you know, but it is a coronavirus. It's not COVID-19, but it's a similar one. So during the whole presentation, you have the virus in the background. The project that he was talking about was the COVID-19 High Performance Computing Consortium in the US, which currently has about 66 projects. And it collects about 483 petaflops of computing power, which is, if you compare it to the Fujaku system, it's slightly more, but not much more. The Fujaku system is in its own about 450 petaflops. In total, there are 40 consortium members, and they, in total, it's about 136,000 nodes that they have collected. And in addition to that, about 50,000 GPUs. That's what Rick told us. I wanted to show this picture because Rick said that there's a strong linkage with the EU Praise COVID-19 initiative. So they're closely working together, America and Europe. These are the systems that are used. So you see, for instance, the Frontera at TAC. And this is the SuperMOOC at LSZ in Munich. So what are they researching? So they're doing all kinds of research into COVID-19, or supporting all kinds of research into COVID-19. And this is the picture that he Rick uses to explain how the virus works, or how it looks like. So you see here on the outside the spikes. You see in the middle the RNA, you have some membranes, and basically that it's not a very complicated thing. So, and you can have drugs or cures that could help for each help for each of those parts. He also gave, which is quite, I didn't quite know that. So it takes about 10 minutes for the virus to enter the cell. So this was research done in the SARS virus, but probably for COVID-19 it's about the same. So this was what Rick told us about replication timescales. The period where it then starts replicating itself, well, and basically that's the only thing that the virus does, it's taking 10 hours. And after that it bursts, and then you get about 1,000 virus parts that are going to infect other cells. Here you see at the bottom the more familiar picture of COVID, and if you would analyze that at the atom level, so include all atoms in the virus, you can do that for a big part, then it would take a tremendous amount of computing time to simulate that. And what they do is they use AI to have a kind of multi-level approach, in this case three levels, where you take coarser simulations of the virus and of the elements that are in the virus. So, the decision which level you are using at a certain moment in your simulation and your calculations, that's done by AI, artificial intelligence. So that's a neat way of trying to get the most out of the computer capacity that you have. If you do that, then you can get, for instance, a large number of hits of candidate drugs. And this is the overall model that Rick said that they were using to try to help at all levels research. So at the highest level, it is a lead generation for high throughput screening of compounds. So you just see, does it work? Could it work? Perhaps. Could it work? Perhaps. And then you do the molecular dynamic simulations with the compounds that you found to see whether it's good enough. And then you can also have to, then experts come in, which also look at the toxicological level. So yeah, the compound could work, but if you die from the compound itself, it's not very a very good drug. And then you drill down to, yeah, okay, we have a good drug. You don't die from it, but can we produce it? Because not all compounds that you can think of, you can produce. And the idea is that they support with computation and high performance computing all these levels. So, and the model that emerges is from that. So, and this is the model on how you put a system together that you can use to do research and to support research. So there are two levels: the molecular, machine learning part, which is the upper part, and the physics-based molecular dynamics part. So machine learning, artificial intelligence, and molecular dynamics parts. And then there are things you can do, and there's a way of getting data from one part to the other. You really should go to the presentation of Rick to understand how this model works. But basically, it's a modern approach to support COVID-19 research and also other type of research in a fast way. So, if you want to see the whole presentation, go to the ISC website, and there you can find the whole presentation of Rick. And if you want to know more and want to see more on what's happening at ISC, please tune in to our channel next time. See you.